I'm Nicholas Haddock, and today I'll be discussing the special topics paper by Drs. Mihai Choi and Nolan Karp focused on BRCA mutations in the young, high-risk female patient population. This article addresses the increased public awareness and genetic mutations that predispose patients to breast cancer, with the specific implications on minors and young adults. The article summarizes the guidelines for both genetic testing and risk reduction surgery in these two patient populations, with the cornerstone of care being coordinated care between multiple disciplines, including genetic counselors, surgical oncologists, oncologists, and plastic surgeons. So for patients, the take-home points are to know that these genetic mutations are still relatively rare. Only 0.2 to 0.3% of the general population is a carrier. Additionally, the increased risk that's often stated with these genetic mutations is a lifetime risk. So by age 70, a BRCA1 patient has a 60 to 65% chance of breast cancer, whereas a BRCA2 patient has a 45 to 55% chance of breast cancer. But by age 30, these patients have a 3.4 or 1.5% risk, respectively. It's also important to understand that there are a number of other mutations. We focus a great deal on BRCA1 and BRCA2, but as we continue to advance, we learn more and more about additional mutations. So for patients that are concerned, when should genetic testing be considered? Well, there are clear guidelines that are dictated by family history, and ultimately, these must be individualized based on the individual's specific first, second degree relatives and history. So specifically, for those that are younger than 18 years of age, what do? Well, generally, we try and avoid screening in minors. The patients cannot consent, and ultimately, the psychological burden that would be given with a positive diagnosis, or potentially even a negative diagnosis, is extreme. Therefore, we try and delay this unless a patient has a specific reason based on a positive patient, family member. What about the young adults, age 18 to 25? Well, this group is more controversial, and I think it has to be individualized. So typically, these patients have to be evaluated for maturity, and ultimately you have to determine if the patient is prepared to manage the sequelae of either a positive or a negative result. And then we have to decide, what will we do with that information? Will risk reduction surgery be offered? So talking about risk reduction surgery, this typically means a mastectomy, which can reduce the risk of breast cancer by 90%. And in this patient population, it's often a nipple-sparing mastectomy with potentially an implant or a flap. The paper focuses a great deal on implants, but it is important to remember that flaps are the only way to provide a lifetime reconstruction. And in this patient population, there's certainly a benefit to that.